The question is, why should, why is Jesus bringing this to Jesus came and see, the greatest gift of the Father in heaven was Jesus Christ, and the greatest gift of Jesus is the Holy Spirit. Greatest gift. Sometimes we lost it.
Because we don't need the Holy Spirit, because we have no connection.
Saint Teresa, Mother Teresa. Who's your favorite saint? Sorry? Mother Teresa. Wow. And who's your favorite saint? No favorite saint? Better say somebody here. Sorry? Mother Teresa. Saint Monica. Only women, excuse me, what happened to guys? Hello? What? Saint Anne. Saint Anne, who is there from? There are many saints, no? My favorite saint is Saint Francis of Assisi. Have you heard? Francis of Assisi is called the second Christ, right? He's called the second Christ, the second Jesus, and he's an amazing man. Absolutely amazing man. I am not saying. Let's take an example. I just want to give an example. This is an example. Let's take the life of Saint Anne. He's everybody knows that Saint Anthony, right? Correct now? Yes or no? Especially when we lose the people. We don't know where we have the time. We know where we know. You know Saint Anthony? He's an amazing saint. I don't know if you read his life. Some people say this, Saint Anthony is my favorite saint. And I ask them, have you read his life? No. Gradually. Your favorite saint, it must be. Get to know the saints. Like making it. Get rid of the life of Saint Anthony. But Saint Anthony is an amazing saint. He's not at the church as a preacher and teacher. Amazing teacher, preacher he was. He had the gift of miracles, working miracles. It's amazing. It must be his life. You'd be amazed. What we see today is nothing. Saint Anthony was a miracle worker. Wow. Saint Anthony had this gift of buying. Do you know what is a bilocation? That means you can be seen in two or three time places, no? At the same time, 11 a.m. Saint Anthony's here and in Ruby also. The gift of bilocation, amazing man. Let me ask you a question. Listen to me carefully. Yes, Saint Anthony. Yes, the Holy Spirit. Are they on the same level?
No.
Yes or no?
No.
Yes or no? Yes or no? Why?
Holy Spirit is God.
Holy Spirit is who?
God.
Holy Spirit is who? God. Not at the same level. So why don't you pray a little more to the Holy Spirit? Little more. Surely you pray to Saint Anthony. He's going to pray to Saint Augustine. He said to pray to Saint Francis. But pray more to the Holy Spirit. He is your God. Let me ask you another question quickly. How many of you sit here think you're going to go to heaven? What does the church have? How much praise does it have? Unbelievable. Can you raise your hand? You want to say, I think they operate on this. Raise your hand. How many of you think they're going to heaven? Raise your hand. Let me see. Fantastic. Super. Super. Some are not praising. Some are not. I think so. Boring. comes right through every letter written by St. Paul. That's simple. I want to give you a few of these truths. Romans chapter 8, verse 1. See what St. Paul is saying. Check out your name. Brothers, sisters, your existence in all the flesh, but in the spirit, because the spirit of God is within you. If you do not have the spirit of Christ, you will not belong to him. What is St. Paul saying? The spirit of God is within you. Where is the Holy Spirit in you? In other words, where is God in you? And in this realization, you stop searching for God. You stop searching for God. If you search for God, you search for him within you. He's in you. St. Paul is saying, he dwells within you. That is the power of the Holy Spirit. Through that wisdom, all Catholics have received the Holy Spirit. So there's a new truth coming in. Jesus is just not Emmanuel. God with us, and he is with us and in us. What does it mean? It means this way, right?
Who came to the playground saw one group sitting in a circle and praying.
only make sure you live the gospel values. The Holy Spirit is not clear there. No, but I think some of these stories is told me, no, not copying it. It's a wrong value. I'll change. I never copy out of it. Why is the Holy Spirit become very active in my life? Because you can act in the study of the truth. You are thinking about the compromise. Make sure I live the right life. And that's what happened in my life. That is the power of the Holy Spirit. It will change our values. It will change our thinking. It will change the way we live. And that is the way Paul said, you know, brothers and sisters, your existence is not in the flesh, but in the spirit. Because the spirit of God is within you. He dwells within you. Wow. I'm sure you are familiar with this passage. 1 Corinthians 3:16. Shall we read it? Do you not know that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit dwells in you? What is it? Paul said, your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Wow. Why the temple of the Holy Spirit? Because the Holy Spirit dwells in you. Amen. Say hallelujah. Can you tell your brother and sister you are the temple of the Holy Spirit? Say something here. You got to move on.
Because of sin, because we don't pray to Him, because we don't try to Him, He will come down.
sick and be married. Yeah, married a wrong person. Now carry the cross. Yeah. This pastor once was preaching his church, and he told all the people in his church, hey, next Sunday when you come to church, bring all your problems, bring all your fears, bring all your crosses, we are going to pray, and everything is going to be perfect. And everybody next Sunday came to the church, bringing their crosses, bringing their problems. One person came to the church, carrying his wife on the shoulder. He said, Pastor, this is my wife, this is my cross. Pastor said, sorry, with this cross I came to nothing, continue to carry. Sorry, no joy. So, how many people know that marriage is a cross? Yeah, marriage is a big cross. Married, fell in love, but love fell out. You know why? Sometimes, maybe, I'm not saying she or he is the wrong person, but they're not going through our marriage. Not going through our marriage. So, what I'm trying to say is, he will get into it. You know, if you're a married person, you know, you're going to be passionate in your life. It's God. Oh, he's fallen in love with God and this house for him. How nice of him. Please. So, when the Holy Spirit is dormant, that means you're not praying, you become a devotee. Remember yesterday he said, God is calling us to become what? Devotees want to be servants. Just doing for the sake of doing. Just praying. Just going here. Going for it. We pray. Nothing happens. How many people do this, right? We pray. We go for a dinner. We say the rosary. We go for retreats. We go for dimensions. No change. No change. Zero change. Who is the disciple? Yes, he prays the rosary. He goes for a dinner. He is the word of God. His life is changing little by little. Amen. That is the path of resurrection. When the Holy Spirit is not active in your life, you become this. I call them 3D Catholics. 3D Catholics. You know who they are? Yeah. 3D. What is this? Dressing? Dancing? That's what we say to some people. We call them what? Party Catholics. Have you heard of the word? Party animal. Without a party, you cannot survive. I'm not saying you shouldn't have a party. Yes, we are all social beings. God has made us like that. We have to interact. But some people only live or exist for parties. Yeah, 3D. Don't become 3D, please. Don't become 3D. Yeah? You know why? Because the Holy Spirit is God. The God in your life, emptiness is there. Try to fill your life with emptiness. Remember St. Augustine's word? You know what St. Augustine said? Our hearts are made for thee, O Lord. It cannot rest unless it rests in thee. St. Augustine says. And that's why it's important for us to open our lives to God. So when the Holy Spirit is not active in our government, everything will become holy. Especially, I don't need to draw attention to the religion. We come late. We don't know what is happening. No, some people don't know. But why is this? A priest was celebrating the Eucharist, part of the India. Celebrating the Eucharist, 6:30 in the morning, sleepy congregation. Saturday night, they finished the fever. Sunday, they take home mass, and finish now. Sleepy congregation. No, they lacked it right. They lacked it right. Everybody knows what happened, right? So this priest was celebrating the Mass. Tell you what. Next Friday or Sunday or whatever, yeah, Sunday. Next Friday we come to church.
When the last song is sung, you get up and go to the Lord.
Who are you? Right?
You get up and go to the door. in closing, I want to say, learn to fellowship more with the Holy Spirit. Fellowship is what? Relationship, friendship. Pray more to the Holy Spirit. I would encourage you to pray more to the Holy Spirit. Now, wherever I go, I have Jesus across the nations. Why? You want to establish a good relationship with the third person of the Trinity. Everything will come out of you. Yeah? So when you do it, you want to. Let me.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Happy one. He was sleeping, you know. Remember? storm came, right?
And then they're asking Jesus, Master, now why are you asking the ground?
Suddenly, somebody hit me from behind. I looked.
COVID shadow. But he jumped out in this auto, came in front of me and said, "You need to be." You know, you can't argue this guy, right? It's not easy to argue this guy. He stood in front of me and argued with me, "You need to be." Come to the side.
See, the mentor will be doing it at the point. You won't be punishing.
the last point is, Holy Spirit take control. Amen. Jesus is not us. If you pray every day to the Holy Spirit take control of my life, what will the Holy Spirit do? Take control of my life. And what will the Holy Spirit take control of my life? You want to be very, very sure. What is the context sure? Your life will go the way God wants it to go. Amen.
Amen.
You will live a life pleasing to God. Amen.
Amen.
Because the Holy Spirit. the word of God ministered to you, because now you are connecting with the author of the word of God. Amen. You'll be amazed. Amen. Say hallelujah.
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 Dear brothers and sisters, now we have the connection line before you now. So I request you all of you to be very generous. And as the connection is made, we will sing the song to the Holy Spirit. And we all, you want to stand, you stand, you want to sit, you sit, you have to do whatever you want to have. But as the connection is moving around, let the Holy Spirit also move in us and be blessed for whatever you are going to do.
As soon as the connection is over, we ask Father to expose the sacrament, Father. We just have a short of benedictions. Thank you for enabling appear the last few evenings. Pray, say, Lord, may your word be much fruit in my life. I want to become your disciple. I don't want to give you lip service, Lord. I don't want to live a double life. I want to be sincere, faithful in following you. And thank you for your Holy Spirit, Lord. Because without the power of the Holy Spirit, it is impossible to live a disciple. It is impossible to be a disciple of Jesus Christ.
I want to
They already done. That tomorrow 9 to 4 o'clock is the seminar, and then of course we have the parish retreat tomorrow evening of the mass, where I will speak to you on when the Holy Spirit comes, the activity in your life, and when the Holy Spirit, what he can do for you. It's absolutely amazing. Yeah, what he can do for you. Yeah, we will do that. Yeah. Is there any other announcement before we leave?
Just two announcements. For tomorrow's session, the sheets for registration are kept out. And just to mention that there is no charge, because someone is asking, there is no charge at all that we want you, dear brothers and sisters, to come and benefit from this session. So please put down your name and your telephone number. Okay? That's all.
Is that so? Yes, raise your hands to the Lord and thank the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise you. Bless your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. May your holy name be praised, Lord. May your name be blessed, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Thank you for this evening, Lord. Thank you for the priceless gift of the Holy Spirit, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise your name. Bless your name. Glory for your name. Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Hear me. Full of grace.